Out to the Middle East, where Foreign Minister Penny Wong has promised over $20 million in humanitarian aid during her visit to Israel. Live to Ash Mullaney, who's in Tel Aviv for us. Ash, this is for Palestinians affected by the war.
Matt, the first stop for Penny Wong today was Jordan, where she expressed her grave concern about the humanitarian crisis in Gaza. She pledged $21.5 million in humanitarian aid that will go to aid agencies and refugees that have been displaced by the war. But she has also taken time this afternoon, having arrived in Israel, to speak with families of hostages who are still being held captive by Hamas and to express her solidarity with Israel. Those families told me they were deeply touched by this. It meant the world to them because it said that to them that the world hadn't forgotten about them and their loved ones.
The most powerful thing was the opportunity and the privilege of speaking with the families of hostages, and it was incredibly moving. And you know, this 102 days has been just devastating for them, and I'm really grateful for that opportunity.
There was some controversy before Penny Wong's arrival in the Middle East because her itinerary doesn't include any plans to visit those border towns where Hamas carried out those atrocities. She said, though, she plans to not only meet with hostage families, as she's done this afternoon, but victims of those attacks too.
Yeah, very delicate diplomacy there. Ash, there's also been new developments overnight in the Red Sea.
Really worrying, Matt. We've seen the Houthi rebels from Yemen strike another cargo ship this afternoon. This time, it is a Greek cargo ship. 24 crew on board. Thankfully, no reports of injuries. It's believed that ship was on its way to an Israeli port. We saw another one targeted yesterday. The Americans have also carried out another airstrike today in Yemen, although not as big, not as significant as those earlier strikes with the UK, but they've taken out four anti-ship ballistic missiles. They called it a dynamic strike, which means they probably got intel that they were about to carry out another strike and they've gotten in ahead of them. Matt?
Yeah, the chaos continues. Ash Mullaney in Tel Aviv for us. Thank you. And in major breaking news this morning, British oil company Shell has indefinitely suspended all Red Sea shipments as the Yemen-based Houthi rebels continue to attack commercial vessels. So far, Shell has not commented, but BP and Qatar Energy have now taken similar precautions. The news now leading to fears of a spike in petrol prices. Here's Nat.